Kobolds are nature spirits, most commonly invisible and seen to the mortal eye, though they can take nearly any form they desire. There are three main forms of kobolds. The first we are going to look at are house kobolds. They are commonly the size of children and dressed like peasants. They are friendly and helpful, tending to household chores and assisting in keeping things in good repair. If mistreated or insulted, they can become mischievous, playing pranks and doing malicious deeds around the home they were formerly helpful to. To appease them, leave them gifts of milk, honey, and cookies. Mine kobolds or knockers are the second type. They were known to warn miners of cave-ins to indicate the presence of valuable ores and generally be helpful in tending the tools and equipment of the miners. They could also cause dangerous mischief if they were not respected. The cave-ins would be caused by them. Tools would go missing and valuable ore would be swept out for something not valuable. The last type is the Klabautermann. They served aboard boats, being small and largely invisible. They would work the ship, remaining unseen. If ever they should be seen by a crewman, it was a warning that the ship was doomed. Curiosity killed the cat. In this story, a shipload of men faced a watery death due to the curiosity of one of their crew. Come, let's see what led up to their gruesome fate. There was once a ship called the Tide Runner. She was a beautiful vessel which carried 40 seamen, including their captain, on board. She was a fishing vessel, and a lucky one at that. Every day, they could catch up to a ton of fish. The crew were a jolly bunch and made merry daily after a good catch. Among these 40 individuals, there was another, though rarely seen by the crew. This invisible crewman helped the upkeep of the ship. He stored away fishing nets once they dried and smoked kippers for the crewmen to have tea. He also cleaned the cabins where the crewmen slept and kept the galley well stocked. One of the crewmen, a young man by the name of Jonas, was extremely intrigued by the goings-on. He asked Captain Finn one afternoon, "Captain, how come the ship is well kept when no one is free enough to clean up?" The captain turned towards Jonas and said in a gruff voice, "Me lad, be thankful to the Klabautermann. He who cleans the ship must be respected and thanked. But never you mind seeing him. If you do, we are all doomed." Jonas's flames of curiosity were stoked by Captain Finn. "I'd really like to know who this Klabautermann is. It couldn't be that dangerous, eh?" thought Jonas to himself. With that, he decided to sneak a peek tonight, after another of his comrades set out some smoked kippers and biscuits as an offering. Little did he know, his actions were about to set a string of events that he wouldn't be around to remember. That night, Jonas stayed awake, looking out at the deck where the offerings were kept. At one point, he nodded off with tiredness. At midnight, he was awoken by the smell of tobacco. Rubbing his sleep-filled eyes, he trailed his gaze to the deck. There, Jonas saw a man dressed in yellow with a green woolen cap perched atop his head. The man was smoking a pipe with a smoked kipper in the other hand. Jonas rushed up to the deck and said to the man, "Are you the mysterious Klabautermann the captain said was helping us?" When the man turned, Jonas had the rudest shock, hair standing on his neck. The man's face was covered in shiny scales, and where his nose should be, there were gills. Jonas stumbled backwards. The Klabautermann replied in a watery voice, "Yes, it's a young man, but now that you have seen me, you and your mateys will sink to the bottom of the sea and join me in my fishy abode." With that, The Klabautermann dived overboard into the inky depths. Jonas shivered and shook. Thunder rumbled overhead, and violent waves crashed against the ship, making her groan against the force. The captain, who had awakened with a frightful storm, tried to steer the ship to calmer waters, but struck a coral reef. The ship slowly sank as water flowed into her, claiming the lives of the 40 seamen. The last thought that went through Jonas's mind was, "I wish I listened to the captain. We'd still be alive today." The end. For the 7th fairy friend, we'll be meeting changelings, my little ones. Stay tuned and sleep tight.